गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू. गुड मॉर्निंग. राइट राइट. नाउ लिसन, यस्टरडे वी वर डिस्कसिंग रिगार्डिंग दिस कैलकुलस पार्ट. आई ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू इफ देर इज अ फंक्शन y, dy by dx is called slope of the tangent drawn to the curve at a particular point. Again I am repeating, dy by dx is nothing but slope of the tangent drawn to a particular point on the curve. So y is a function, so keep that point in mind. Now we all discuss these points. Derivative of a constant is 0, d by dx of constant is 0. Why? Constant cannot change. Actually it is dy by dx, dy by dx, y equal to k. So constant cannot change, so no change in the constant, so it is 0. Pure constant, for a pure constant derivative is 0. The slope finding is also called derivatives. D by dx of log x is 1 by x. In other words, how do you read that in English? If you say, if you draw a tangent on log x curve at a particular point, slope of that tangent is, slope of the tangent
is
1 by x.
1 by x, right. If I draw a tangent on sin x curve, slope of the tangent is cos x. Yeah, d by, actually it is dy by dx, y is sin x, here y is cos x, and so on. So keep that point in mind. Dy by dx is nothing but slope finding. Afterwards we have another concept called integration, that I will tell you afterwards, that is finding the area. Actually why we are finding slope, why we are interested to learn about slopes, because slopes give you some physical quantities. Again I am repeating, slopes give you some physical quantities. Always slope need not give the physical quantity. Again I am repeating, in physics slope of some functions give you some physical quantity. Example, yesterday I was dealing, I am taking a new page, listen. Yesterday I have taken s equal to ut plus half a t square. All of you remember that? S equal to ut plus half a t square. Now again I am repeating that so that everyone can follow carefully. Differentiate s with respect to time. The two variables in that equation are s and t. The two variables in that equation are s and t. S is one variable, t is variable. U is a constant, a is a constant. So ds by dt equal to derivative of t is 1 u plus half a t square is 2t. This comes to ds by dt equal to u plus at. Now listen. Many students, of course those who have been in foundation before, you can understand, but some of the student may not know. Whenever you have x power 3, derivative of this will be, bring the 3 on the left hand side, 3x power minus 1 from the power, minus 1 from the power, that is all. Similarly, if I take x power 4, derivative of this will be 4x cube, and so on. If I take x, what is the derivative of this?
One.
This is 1, no?
1,
this is 1 there. 1 x power 1 minus 1, 1 x power 0, x power 0 is 1. So, one. 1 will be the answer there. So keep that point in mind. So slope, this is slope in ST graph. Are all of you able to see the board clearly?
Yes sir.
Yes sir.
Very good. Slope in ST graph. Remember, slope in ST graph is giving a physical quantity instantaneous velocity. Instantaneous velocity. I am going on slowly because remember, out of all the three subjects, physics actually it's easier. Only thing you have less number of formula. Understanding is required more. There is nothing to by heart here. Okay, understanding is required more. Mathematics, you have to remember so many formula everywhere, chemistry also, but here pure understanding is required. The slope in ST graph is instantaneous velocity. So, I can write this as V, or I can write V equal to U plus AT. Now, listen, I am just taking these two, this one and this one. This is called original equation, this is called slope equation. Once again I am repeating. In that first box, that is the original equation, this is the slope equation. From these two equations are the main points to draw the graph. If you know the original equation and slope equation, you can draw the graph. Otherwise, you will not know how to draw the graph. Till 10th standard you by hearted. Now you will know how to draw it. You should know whether the slope is increasing or decreasing. Accordingly you have to draw the graph. For example, see, if I draw y versus x like this, can anyone tell me slope is increasing or decreasing for this graph? Decreasing. Why? See the steepness here, more steep, less steep, less steep. Put a tangent, draw a tangent. If the steepness of the tangent is less, slope is less. If the steepness is less, slope is less. Draw the tangent here, steepness less. Draw the tangent here, steepness less. Lesser the steepness, lesser the slope. So slope is decreasing. Very good. Now I can see so many students. I am very happy now. I am very happy because you have to be attentive. Whether you can understand 50% or 80% or 90%, no problem. You have to be attentive. Gradually you learn. Very soon offline classes will start. Then we will come together. Then you can have more interaction. Slope is decreasing. Now if I take, look at this, y versus x, one of you tell me, increasing or decreasing?
Increasing, sir.
Increasing. How to identify that is, draw the tangent, or imagine one boy standing here, one boy standing here, at A, at B. Where is the steepness more?
B, sir.
B, sir.
That means slope is more, slope is increasing. So, drawing the graph is a great talent. That great talent you will get only with two equations. One is the original equation, other is slope equation.
Slope equation.
So, if you want to draw ST graph, you have to get the ST equation and the slope equation for that. You have to get the ST equation and the slope equation for that. Now, we got both. Now, I will come back for drawing it. Now, listen. This is ST. Always take time on the x-axis. Always take time on the x-axis. Remaining quantity on the y-axis. Whether it may be speed, of course, velocity, or it may be acceleration, momentum, whatever it is, or displacement, it should be on the y-axis. Now come on, take the original equation. At t equal to 0, s is how much?
0.
At t equal to 0, s is 0. That means where is the coordinate? X comma y, the coordinate is here, 0 comma 0, at origin. From there, the graph should either increase or decrease. We have to see. Look at the slope, ds by dt. u plus at. U is a constant initial velocity, a is a constant time. As time increases, this total quantity u plus, the total quantity u plus at will increase. So slope is increasing. Now I will draw two graphs, you have to tell me which is right. Which is correct?
Graph B, sir.
Graph B is correct. So I am cleaning this A. Now listen. So now you understood how to draw the graph. Look at this. Right. S versus time. Slope is increasing. Slope is increasing. Steepness is increasing.
Yeah.
Now listen carefully. How to get the initial condition? If I draw a tangent here, it makes an angle theta. Now you may ask me, sir, how do you know it will make some angle? Why can't theta be 0? Now come back. Slope.
At time increases, slope increases.
T equal to 0. How much? At T equal to 0, what is the slope?
Slope also increases.
0.
0.
No. Check. I'll put T equal to 0, but you are left with?
Increase.
U.
What is that?
No.
At slope at T equal to 0 is U. That means slope is not 0 at T equal to 0. Slope is not 0 at T equal to 0. That means tan theta at T equal to 0 is U.
Sir, 1
that
x
is slope
0.
Is U. You know in 10th standard tan theta is a slope. I am drawing theta at origin. Tan theta should give you slope. But slope at T equal to 0 is U. So tan theta is U. So what is the initial slope? U.
U.
Sub U. Very good. Suppose the body is starting from rest. Listen carefully. If the body is starting from rest, U will be how much?
Zero.
Then zero. At T equal to 0, what is the slope?
Zero.
Constant.
Then
constant.
I will get a tangent parallel to
x-axis.
X-axis. Then theta will be how much?
Zero.
Tan theta will be how much?
Zero, sir.
Yeah, initial velocity is zero. See the wonderful point there. Tomorrow in the once in the mains, very simple question was asked. ST graph is given like this. ST graph is given, and one angle they gave here. Theta is 30 degrees. They asked initial velocity. Many students did not answer. Initial velocity means ds by dt is slope, but slope has become velocity. You agree? The slope has become instantaneous velocity. So tan theta, how much there? Tan 30? Tan 30.
1 by root 3.
Very good. 1 by root 3. That means the initial velocity of the body is 1 by root 3 meters per second. Depending on the SI unit. I am taking it as SI unit. So, what is the answer for initial velocity for this graph?
1
by root 3 meters per second.
Meter per second.
How to get that velocity? Write the original equation. Write the slope equation. In this, the slope equation is nothing but instantaneous velocity of the particle. Again, I am repeating. In this case, the slope has given you a physical quantity. The slope has given you a physical quantity. What is that physical quantity?
Instantaneous velocity.
Instantaneous velocity. Very good. Okay. Write down these points as it is. Here, one example you can take. I will give this example afterwards. First, write down these points. I am so happy today because I can see all my students are attending the class, that only I want. You may think physics, many students have opinion, physics very difficult. Physics is the easiest actually for you. Because less things to remember. You have so many things to remember in mathematics, so many things to remember in chemistry. You may think other subjects are easier, sir, physics something difficult. No, I am telling you today, after the start of the session, your regular course, any student who understands clearly, this is the only subject where you need not by heart anything. So keep that point in mind. Once you complete, let me know. Because why I am saying, our director sir has given so much of a facility here, and when I was very depressed yesterday, first class some students are coming, because you are at home, you are taking freedom. Whether the parent looks at you or not, you should be listening to all the classes. That is important. When the parent is looking at you, one class you listen, other class, you are cheating yourself. I am not telling all those who are missing. Don't ever miss any class. Two more students I found that they got up and went. They have to take permission. Anyone who wants to go should take permission. I will give permission. But very carefully you have to listen every point.
Velocity.
Have you completed this?
Sir, 1 minute, sir.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, sure, sure. I'll just slightly, I will reduce it. Yeah. Yesterday, Sma? Sivaram Krishna, you are speaking to me or Bhumaitri? Bhumaitri. Yeah, it will be done today. Today you will get it. Yesterday I was angry, I was shouting in the last 5 minutes. Now I am so happy my students all are sitting there and listening very carefully. You will see after 1 year, you will wonder, you will tell me, sir, I can do it in a better way. Like that you will become expert than the teacher. We only will teach you, you will become expert afterwards. For that, every class you have to listen. Those students who succeeded in IIT or NEET or any engineering or medical are the ones who were having attendance 100%. Why? I will tell you the secret. If you miss one class, the next day it will become Greek and Latin. You can't understand anything. So that is very important. So every student should keep in mind, attending is very important. Anyone, XYZ student can say, sir, I didn't understand, I understood only 80%, I understood only 70%, no problem, but you have to attend. If you don't understand, if you don't attend, you will not understand that 70% also. Next day class will become Greek and Latin, you will not know anything. In my career, I have seen all students who succeed in IIT are having good attendance percentage. That is most important. Right. So, write down one point what I am going to tell you now. One point, write note. Note, to draw the graph, the original equation and slope equation are required. The original equation and slope equations are required. Yeah, to draw the graph, original equation and slope equation are required. Are required. Next point. Substituting.
Sir, can you repeat the sentence?
Substituting the initial conditions. The graph can be drawn. Substituting the initial conditions given. Graph can be drawn. Now, what is the secret of drawing the graph? Two conditions. The original equation, slope equation. Substitute the initial conditions. The problem is solved. Now, I will give you one example. A car moves along a straight line. Write down. A car moves along a straight line. A car moves along a straight line governed by the equation s equal to t square plus 1. Where s, a car moves along a straight line governed by the equation s equal to t square plus 1, where s is the displacement and t is the time. Now listen, a car is going according to this equation. S is the variable displacement, t is another variable. Okay, now my first question, write down. Find the displacement in first 2 seconds.
Sir, one sir.
Let us see. In the first 2 seconds. Find the displacement in first 2 seconds.
Four, sir.
Okay, who is that told four?
Sivaram Krishna,
first 2 seconds. Sivaram Krishna, how tell me 4?
Sir, ds by dt is equal to 2t, no sir.
Okay.
1 constant 0, no sir.
Okay.
In t we replace 2 into 2, 4, no sir.
I did not ask velocity. What is ds by dt?
Yes, sir.
Velocity. No, what is ds by dt?
2t, sir.
No. What is actually ds by dt? Instantaneous?
Instant velocity.
Velocity, sir.
But I did not ask that. I asked
displacement.
I did not ask instantaneous velocity.
5. Displacement is 5.
Any student who gets up should take. Otherwise, I'll note down. I asked the management to note down. You should not get up from your place without permission. Yeah. Now anyone tell me, I want only displacement.
Displacement 5.
Let us see. Anyone else? 5. Answer, someone told 5. Gautam told 5.
Yes, sir.
5. Okay. So simple, no? Let us see. what all told. S naught. S naught mean at t equal to 0. At the starting, where is the particle or the car? T equal to 0, 1. T equal to 2, 2 square plus 1, 5. Of course, I am taking SI unit meters. Now listen, the car was initially at S naught equal to 1. It means if I draw the graph, say the car is going like this, already at it is there at S naught equal to 1. It is not at origin. Then it is at 5. How much the car moved? Yeah, so what is the displacement? 5 minus 1, 4. Already the car occupied a position.
Yes sir, okay sir.
Yeah, at t equal to 0, already car occupied some position. From there it has gone to 5. So what is the displacement?
Sir.
Yeah, so displacement.
4 meters.
5 minus 1, 4 meters. Write down that, all of you. So answer will be 4 meter.
4.
Gautam or someone meter, told ds by dt. I am not going to ds by dt.
Sir?
I am not going to that point. I am just finding displacement in the first 2 seconds. First 2 means what you will do? First put t equal to 0. Mute yourself. Gautam, Chandras. At t equal to 0, where is the car? 1 meter. At t equal to 2, where is the car? At x equal to 5. How much it has moved?
4 meters.
4 meters. And that fellow will give option 1 meter, 4 meter, 5 meter, 10 meter. Many students will choose 5 meter. Wrong. 4 meter is correct. So, sum is so simple, no? But you should be very, very careful. So what you have to check is at t equal to 0, where is the car? At t equal to 2, where is the car? How much it has moved? Like that you have to check. Simply don't substitute the value of t directly.
Sir?
At t, tell me.
Sir, at position 1, how t can be 0, sir? If it had travelled a certain distance, time cannot be 0, na?
No, I will tell you. From your home, from your house, this is your house, right? From there, you travelled 1 meter and stopped there. Your car is already, your parking place is there. At what distance? 1 meter. That means the position of the car is counted from your home. At t equal to 0, where is your car?
S is equal to 1.
Yeah, it's already parked there. Reference is your home. At t equal to 2, where is the car from home? At t equal to 2, where is the car from home? From
five
home
meters,
to the car, how much?
5 meters.
5 meters. How much it travelled?
4 meters.
See the beautiful point
four
there.
4 meters, sir.
The reference is your home. Suppose the car was here, then it had travelled 5 meters. That is why always you have to check where is the car from the reference. Your reference is origin. From the origin, where is the car initially? 1 meter.
1 meter.
After 2 seconds, where is the car?
5 meters. 5 meters
from the origin. So how much that it has travelled? How much it has travelled?
4 meters.
4 meters.
Very good. Very good. Have you noted down that?
Sir, that means.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, tell me.
Sir, that means the car has travelled In 1 second, it has after 1 second it has traveled with non-uniform velocity. Non-uniform velocity.
Yeah, yeah. I'm not talking about velocity. I want only displacement. So this already this is a displacement equation. Catch hold of this fellow. I am not talking about velocity at all.
Sir, for anyism we can use that formula s is equal to t square plus 1 for any problem.
No ma, I gave you the question here. Not for anyism. I gave the question that car is travelling according to that equation. That equation can change. In the question it will be given. So you need not worry about that. It may be t square plus 1, it may be t square plus 10, anything.
Sir, that means the car has travelled a certain distance of 1 meter and from there it has travelled 4 meters then
further.
5 meters.
Okay, sir.
Exactly. So what is your work? You have to put t equal to 0 and check where is a car. Then you have to put t equal to 2 and check where is a car. Then S2 minus S0 gives you the displacement of the car. Very simple. I am cleaning this part now. So what is the displacement you got?
4 meter.
Now
distance also 4?
Yeah, distance also 4. Why? It's going along a straight line. It's going along the straight line. Whenever a particle moves along the straight line, distance and displacement are equal. Are same. Next question. I can see some of them got up from their place. They have to take permission, I said. I should not repeat this sentence again. Write down next one. Find the instantaneous velocity. Find the instantaneous velocity at the end of 2 seconds. After completing all this, I will explain once again. Understanding becomes difficult first. Once you understand, afterwards you will take hardly 1 minute to do the problem. That is the secret here.
Sir, 4 meters.
I will tell you. Find the instantaneous velocity at the end of 2 seconds.
4, sir.
At the end of 2 seconds. Yes, someone?
4, sir.
I think 5.
4, sir.
4. Sivaram Krishna four, says 4. Meter per second. Of course, this is SI unit, okay? SI unit. Now listen, let us see. To find the instantaneous velocity, differentiate this ds by dt. How much is t square? 2t. One derivative 0. But this instantaneous velocity is nothing but slope. Of course, the slope is nothing but v. So, what is the instantaneous slope of ST graph? Remember, slope of ST graph gives you instantaneous velocity. Slope of ST graph. How do you know it will give instantaneous velocity? Displacement by time. A small displacement by a small interval of time gives you instantaneous velocity. So, now substitute 2 into 2, 4. So, what is the answer?
4 meter per second.
Very good. Those who said 4, that's right. 4 meter per second. Because 1 is a constant, derivative of a constant is 0. Now, I differentiated because I want instantaneous velocity. Previously, I did not differentiate because I want displacement.
Displacement.
That's all. Write down that. In ST graph, slope of ST graph, you can write directly, slope of ST graph gives instantaneous velocity. Slope of ST graph gives instantaneous velocity. slope of ST graph gives instantaneous velocity. Now at t equal to 2 we got 4 meter per second. That means before 2 second we don't know its velocity. See, what is the initial velocity of the car? Velocity equation is here, v equal to 2t. What is the initial velocity of the car?
2, sir. 0.
Very good, 0. I need not give in the sum. Directly you will know t equal to 0, v is 0. So the car started from
rest.
Very good. That means this equation is enough to know everything about the car. That equation is enough to know everything about the car.
Car, sir.
Exactly. So what is the initial velocity of the car?
Zero.
Write that point.
Zero,
initial
sir.
Velocity of the car is zero. Initial velocity of the car is zero. At t equal to zero, v is zero. Write down that point. Initial velocity of the car is zero.
Sir.
Yeah, tell me.
Explain about derivatives, sir.
What is ds by dt? Is it not derivative? Gautam?
Sir, I mean that how you have taken that in place of 1, you taken 0, no, sir.
Constant.
Constant. Yesterday, were you present, Gautam? Yesterday?
No, sir.
Differentiation of constant, no, sir. 0, sir.
See. Now, all the students who are present here should not move out of their places. You have to take permission. Yesterday, Gautam was not there. That is why he didn't know how derivative of constant is 0. That is why I am telling you again and again. Whether you understand 20% or 30% or 40% or 90%, you have to see that you are present. Then only the next class you can understand. Be careful. So always keep in mind, you, whether your parent is looking at you or not, student should be attentive in the class. Yesterday Gautam was absent, so he did not know how 1 has become 0. I will explain, don't worry. Gautam, I will explain.
Okay, sir.
Why I am emphasizing more on attendance is, one day if you are absent, the next day it will be Greek and Latin. You will not understand anything. That is the most important point. If teacher is absent, no problem. That day no class for you. But if the student is absent, he will miss lot of things. So, what is the initial velocity of the car? Zero. Next slide. Draw ST graph. Next question. Draw ST graph. Draw ST graph and VT graph. ST means you write like this, S dash T, V dash T. Draw ST graph and VT graph. Now listen carefully. To draw the ST graph, you require two equations. Original equation, slope equation. Original equation is here, slope equation is this one. So, ST graph if you want to draw, I am drawing it here. ST, always time on the x-axis. Now, at t equal to 0, what is S?
1.
See the wonderful point here. At t equal to 0, I am writing it here. At t equal to 0, S is 1. That means coordinate is 0, 0, 1. Yes or no? At t equal to 0, s is 1. Where the point will be, can you guess?
On y-axis.
On y-axis.
0, 1.
Yeah.
Along the
this is 0,
1, sir.
1. From there, you should know how to draw the graph. Whether it is a straight line or decreasing slope or increasing slope. Come back to the slope equation.
Sir, decreasing.
Come back to the slope equation.
Sir, at the origin.
No, no, no. First tell me, at t equal to 0, it will not start from origin. Because s is 1 already. Now come back to slope equation. At t equal to 0, what is the slope?
0.
0. This is the slope equation.
0, sir.
Because slope in ST graph is V. At t equal to 0, slope is 0. As t increases, what will happen to slope?
Slope increases.
Increase, right. Sir.
Now listen here. Is it right? Slope is increasing or not?
Yes, sir.
Look here. Less slope. More slope, more slope, more slope. Steepness is increasing, steepness is increasing. Now, this is the graph. If I draw like this, look at this. This is wrong. Slope is decreasing. Check here. Slope is decreasing. If a child is standing here, and here, slope is decreasing. At A more slope, at B less slope. So that is wrong. So I am going to draw like this. S, T, this is 0, 1 and this is the graph. Now tell me, at T equal to 0, what is the slope? At T equal to 0, slope is?
Zero.
Zero. That means if I draw one tangent here, that should be parallel to time axis. If I draw a tangent at t equal to 0, the tangent should be parallel to time axis. Any line parallel to the x-axis, slope is how much?
Zero.
Zero. So, this is the tangent. Now, this is the graph. Draw the graph, all of you, ST graph. See, like how Gautam asked, that is why I am telling, everyone should be present. When you are present, then only, I told you before only, we are going to start mathematical part in your physics. If you miss, everything will become Greek and Latin the next day. So, I am telling you this very, emphasizing more on this point again and again. So, if I draw a tangent at t equal to 0, it should be parallel to the time axis. That is a ST graph. Now, below that, write the points.
Sir, 1 minute.
Yeah, write down. Actually, in your 8th, 9th, 10th standard, you are at leisure. You are not accustomed to hard work, most of you. Now it is the time for you to work very hard. Only then you can reach your target. Secret of your success is your attendance. Student who is attending regularly will succeed. Whether he understands 10%, or 90%, that is not the matter. He should attend, then only he will succeed. With my experience, I am telling you, in the National Periodical, I have written articles in 2012, IIT Buzzword. That was too difficult actually for advanced level. then also I was emphasizing this point. Every student should be attentive. Whether he understands 50% or 90%, no problem, but he should be attentive. After 2 years or 1.5 year, he will become an expert. He will succeed anywhere. IIT or NEET or NITs, anywhere, you will be in a good position, no doubt. So that is a ST graph. Can I clean this part? Or I can take this up. Right. Now, I asked one more question. Can you tell me what is that? Draw ST graph over. I asked one more question. VT graph. If you want VT graph, first take VT equation. That is the original equation. Now, this VT equation is what? Again, I am going on from the first. I am drawing a line here. V equal to, this is the original equation now. The slope equation in ST graph is the original equation for VT graph. Who can repeat that? Who can repeat?
Sir.
Very good. Write down that. The slope equation in ST graph, the slope equation in ST graph is the original equation for VT graph. Is the original equation for VT graph. Now listen, this is the original equation. I am putting a block here, 1. Now I have to find slope equation for VT graph. Again repeating the same procedure. What are the variables here?
V and T.
V and T. dV by dt. 2. Derivative of T is 1. So what is the answer? 2. Don't say derivative of 2 is 0. 2 is multiplied with T. Any constant multiplied, constant which is multiplied with variable should be taken into account. That is not 0. So 2, derivative of T is 1. So what is the answer? dV by dt?
2.
What is dV by dt? This is
displacement.
Slope in VT graph. This is nothing but, can anyone tell me? Acceleration. Change in velocity by time. 10th standard you learnt. Change in velocity by time. What is that?
Acceleration.
Yeah. That means the slope in VT graph gave a physical quantity acceleration. Again, I am repeating. The slope in VT graph,
yes, sir,
gave you a physical quantity called acceleration. dV by dt is change in velocity by time gives you instantaneous acceleration.
Constant.
That instantaneous acceleration is a constant too. That means in this equation, is there a variable? No variable. That means the car is going with a constant acceleration. The car is going with a constant acceleration. Can I use 10 standard equations of motion for constant acceleration? Yes, we can use. But we have not used, we have adopted a new method called derivative. We differentiated a ST graph and got instantaneous velocity. We differentiated VT graph and got acceleration. Now, taking these two equations, I am going to draw the graph. Let us see. What should I put on the y-axis now?
V.
V. This is T, VT graph. Now, look at this. At T, first you take original equation. At T equal to 0, V is how much?
0.
Where will the point start?
On the origin.
on the origin, at the origin, at the origin.
Yes, sir.
Now, come back to slope. That is why I said substituting yeah, are you able to hear? My dear students, are all of you able to hear me? Yeah, very good. Now listen. Now, slope is, this is the original equation, this is the slope equation. Slope is increasing or decreasing or constant? Constant. Slope is constant.
Straight line,
sir. At t equal to 0, v is 0. Slope is constant means I should get a straight line or not?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, I should get a straight line. That's all. In 10th standard, you by-hearted out to draw. In 11th standard, you are not by-hearting. You are knowing the secret. The secret is the original equation and
slope
equation. From these two, you can draw the graph by taking initial conditions. What is the initial condition? T equal to 0. What is happening to the velocity? 0. 0 comma 0. Come back to slope. Slope is a constant. That means it should be a straight line. So it's a straight line. Now you may ask me, sir, you have drawn straight line like this.
Same,
why
sir.
Can't you draw a straight line parallel to?
Time axis.
Time axis. Sir. If you draw parallel to time axis, slope will be how much?
0.
But slope is not 0, no?
Yes, sir.
Now tell me one of you, tan theta will be how much? You will get a gift from me in the offline class.
Sir, 1.
Tan theta. Think properly and tell me.
1, sir.
Very
one.
Good. Who said 2?
Sir.
Who said 2?
Srikar Reddy, sir.
Srikar Reddy, very good. Slope is 2. That means tan theta is 2. I can find the angle from the logarithm table, Clark's table book. You can find the angle also. See the trick. Once again, I am repeating. From ST graph, you differentiated and got ds by dt and drawn ST graph. After drawing ST graph, if you want VT graph, take VT equation, differentiate again with respect to time. dv by dt is 2. Slope is a constant. If I get dv by dt 0, then the line would have been along the time axis. But slope is a constant, but not 0. Slope is a constant but not 0.
Zero
so it's a straight
zero,
line passing through
origin.
Origin. How do you know it is passing through origin? Taking the original equation. Yeah, at t equal to 0, v is 0. Draw the graph now. Good. Now all students are attentive and listening carefully. I am very happy. So, I got ST graph, you know how to draw the ST graph, now you know how to draw the VT graph. Now, I asked you one question, what is the velocity at the end of 2 seconds, that's over. So, we answered both the questions. One is, what is the displacement? I asked, first write down, I will explain. I can see at the end of the class some students they want to take rest more. You have to get that energy to listen. When you play cricket or football or something, you have so much of energy to watch TV, to watch movie. Actually, when you do problems in maths or physics or chemistry, you will be enjoying when you are doing. when any student finds it like an enjoyment, studies like an enjoyment, that student will surely succeed. Any student who is always present in the class, that student will always succeed. That is a secret of success. Again, I am telling, if teacher is absent one day, no problem for you. If student is absent, it's a big problem. Next day, he will not understand. Gautam, unmute. Gautam, I want, yeah, yesterday you are absent, no Gautam, I'll explain, don't worry. But I liked Gautam so much because one day he took permission from me and then he told some urgency is there, sir, I have to go. I have given.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir.
Again, I am telling you, management need not keep on telling you, come on, listen the class, come on, listen the class. All that is not required. You yourself should be highly interested to be in the class. Very important. So you have drawn the ST graph, VT graph. So V equal to 2T. What is the acceleration here?
2 meter per second square.
Tan theta is 2 because dV by dt is acceleration. But that acceleration is nothing but slope of VT graph. Now, can anyone tell me, if anyone tell me this, I will conclude the class today. AT graph if I take, AT, now you have to take acceleration equation as the original equation. You have to take the acceleration as original equation. Come on. What is the acceleration?
Straight A
equal to 2 meter per. Okay, I am not going to write the unit here. Only the equation. Now, A equal to 2 means it is just like Y equal to 2. Where is A? 0. Very good, very good. 0 comma. How the line will come? Straight. Actually, you have to differentiate this. dA by dt. This side no time. dA by dt is how much? 0. Constant derivative?
0.
0. So, if I differentiate this with respect to time, that's not changing. 2 is 2. 2 cannot be 2.1. No change in 2. So, constant derivative is 2. How the line will come? Can you tell me? Straight line parallel to?
Time axis.
Yes. Draw the graph. Draw the graph. Very good. Very good. Actually, I should differentiate. But common sense here. No need to differentiate. It is just like Y equal to 2. Y equal to 2 means? 0 comma 2. It's a straight line parallel to x axis. We call it as time axis. Always take time on the x axis. Yeah. Very good. Till there you write. First I saw 42 students. Some again slowly in the end of the class some have decreased. I don't want that to happen from tomorrow. Once I see the maximum number here, that maximum number should be there. If I see anyone going out without telling me, I also will go out without telling you. If you agree for that, tomorrow onwards we will have classes. I will be noticing here who are leaving. I will give those names to the management. If anyone goes as you like, I also will put the pen and go as I like. Okay, my dear students, all the best. Yeah, do well. Tomorrow I will give the homework for you. But try to, Gautam, I will explain tomorrow again. Don't worry. In YouTube, it's uploaded. someone asked me today, you can see previous classes are uploaded. Just now I got the information. Okay, bye students, bye. I am happy that all are there. Very good. Okay, ma. Okay, bye, bye.